हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस लेक्चर इज आल्सो अवेलेबल इन द उर्दू एंड हिंदी लैंग्वेज। इफ़ यू वांट टू वॉच इन द उर्दू एंड हिंदी लैंग्वेज, यू कैन टेक द लिंक इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द दिस वीडियो। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज ट्रैफिक सिग्नल कंट्रोल प्रोग्राम इन डेल्टा PLC। दिस इज़ अ लेक्चर नंबर 29। एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल एंड आल्सो लाइक एंड शेयर अवर वीडियो विद योर फ्रेंड्स। As we know, there are three lights in traffic signal. One is red, other is yellow, and last one is green. So when press the start button, the red LED light up for 10 seconds. After it, red LED turn off, a yellow LED light up for 10 seconds. After it, yellow LED turn off and green light up for 10 seconds. After it again yellow light up for 10 seconds and then again red light and repeating same logic again. Okay, this is our today our question and we will make a program according this question. Let's come over Whipple software. Already I have made this. This is a red light, this is a yellow light and this is a green light, but I will make again for you. So I will create a project, lecture number 29, and this is our ES2 PLC. Okay. First we make a on off button, okay. X0 is the our start button and X1 is the stop button. And one output Y0 as a on, or I will latch it by Y0. This is a latching program as I described in my previous lectures. Okay, this is a on off button. Now I will take three outputs. Y1 is for red LEDs. Y2 is for yellow LED and last one is for green Y3. Green LED. ठीक है. Now I will interlock these LEDs. Okay. So I will take normally close Y2 and Y3. Because this is our output Y1, so for interlocking to each other I will take normally close Y2 and Y3. In this way only one LED will on at a time. Okay, this is interlocking of the LEDs. So I copy this for saving my time. And first copy and paste. So as this is our Y2, so I will replace Y2 by Y1. So this is the over output Y3. I will replace Y3 by Y1. Okay, this is the interlocking of the LEDs with each other. Now our logic, when we press on button, Y0 is our on button, then y and y1 LED will be on. Okay, now I will take a timer of 10 seconds. So y1 as the input and it will on our timer. TMR timer and T0 is and K 100 for 10 seconds. Okay, after 10 seconds this light should be off, so I will use here normally close T0. As T0 will on, automatic this Y1 will off because we are using normally close contact. I will add one row more. I will latch this timer by its output T0. Because when our Y1 will off, automatic this also off and this will off our timer. So I am latching the timer by T0. This is the AND OR logic. So same when our timer will on, that our yellow light should be on. So I will use timer T0 here. Okay, it will on our Y2. Same when yellow light will be on, so after 10 seconds it should be off. So I will use another timer. Y2. And a timer for 10 seconds. TMR timer. K 100. Okay, I will more. So when this timer will on, so it should be off for after 10 seconds yellow LED. So I will use here timer 1 in normally closed condition. And this timer I also make off T0. So I again use a timer 1. Okay. Again I latch this timer 1 as I hear for timer 0. Insert a row and latch it by timer 1. Okay, now same timer 1 will on the over green LED. So I will use here timer 1 here. So when timer 1 on the Y3, so it should be here a Y3 and our green light should be on for 10 seconds. So I will use one more timer, timer 2. TM and timer T 2 and K 100. It will for 10 seconds. Okay, so again I latched it by timer 2. Okay, and timer 2 will be off your LED after 10 seconds. Green LED will be off after 10 seconds. T2, and T2 same here, but I will use here. Okay, now I will take more timer for off this timer. So I will take T2 as the input and timer 3 TMR and timer 3 K 100. Okay, and this timer will be off over timer 2. Timer 3. Okay, now compile it. Okay, there are no error, and simulate this program. I will off this one, okay, and run the PLC. And you can see when I start the button, okay, red LED will on for 10 seconds. After Y2 is on, yellow LED, and timer is running. And again green LED on after yellow LED. When this time will complete, and you can see again red light is on, is repeating again, red light on and yellow light will be on. Okay, this is our half program, because our logic is, you can see here in lecture, after green light should be on, must be on yellow light, not red LED. So we use a inverse command for this logic. As I my previous lecture I told you about reverse command, and timer 2 I will use as an input. And inverse command, and use one memory as the output. Okay, when T2, because T2 is timer of Y3, green LED, when timer 2 is on, so it we should be on over this yellow light. So I will insert arrow and insert here timer 2. And I will add here M0 as a normally open, because after completing green light, both Y2 and Y1 will be, condition will be okay. So I use M0, because when T0 is on, automatic M0 will off, because I use inverse command. T on to T2 is on, then M01 on. If T0 on, M0 off, and T0 off, M0 on. So compile it. Now run your program. Okay, as run the PLC and minimize the program, you can see everything. I will set on, and you can see first our red LED on for 10 seconds, then yellow will be on, then Y3 green LED on is our traffic signal lights. After green light, our yellow LED on for 10 seconds. When this is on, after 10 seconds it will be off and this light will be on. Okay, if you have any question regarding this lecture, you can raise a question. Okay, bye.